I am making Filipino adobo. This is spare ribs, and how I do it, if I'm not doing it into the Instapot or the kasoy, so I have the kasoy, it's just like an Instapot. If I do it over the stove, it does taste better, because then you're frying up the meat, whether it's chicken or pork. Pork is the best adobo that the family loves. And then I just brown the meat instead of braising it right away, because then I don't like the dirty parts of the meat when you're boiling it to kind of show. Don't mind the doggies. And I don't think you can really mess up adobo. I don't know, because I've been cooking it for so long. But I put up a couple of bay leaves in there, and you're supposed to use fresh garlic, but honestly I did not. I ran out of fresh garlic because of Thanksgiving. So I just seasoned the meat, salt and pepper generously, and then also garlic powder generously. And then my recipe for adobo. Don't mind the names. I got this from William Sonoma. It's supposed to be like a summer collection, so I just turned it over. And then this is where I put my Hawaiian sea salt, regular salt, pepper, and then garlic powder. But I have about, I always use Danica's cup because this is equivalent to 1 cup. I have half a cup of white distilled vinegar. This is the bay leaf from Trader Joe's. Garlic powder, and then I use Aloha soy sauce. The trick is, I feel that the vinegar. So if you use apple cider vinegar, you can, but it's just going to give it a different taste. Don't use seasoned vinegars like sushi vinegar. Don't use those. It's either just plain white distilled vinegar or, again, apple cider vinegar, but it will give you a different taste. So I prefer the white distilled vinegar. I mix that all in 1 cup, basically, about 4 to 5 tablespoons of soy sauce, and that's it. And then kind of let it cook and until the meat gets softened for about 45 minutes to an hour, and then cook it in low temperature. Okay, so there it is. I added all the liquid. Now I'm just gonna cover it and then let it simmer. Simple, friends. Super easy. Filipino adobo is so easy. Let me turn down the fan, but it's pretty much cooked. So then what I do, you don't have to do this. You can just leave it as is if it's cooked, but I like to take out the meat and put it in and then refry it. So I'm gonna take out all the meat, put it into my container, and then get the sabaw, the soup, put it into the thing. I'm doing this because it's one hand, but basically I just want to refry the meat. Okay. Took out all the juice. Basically, heat up the pan. Just a little bit of oil, because you don't want it to burn. And then high heat. And then we're gonna put the meat back in there, and then brown it. Okay. And then you're only gonna brown this for about a minute or two on each side. Because it's cooked, you're just basically browning the, like, making the meat crunchy. Because you basically braised it. So the ones that you purchase at like the restaurant, this is what they do. To make it taste, it also makes it taste good. That's it. As you guys can tell, it's falling off the bone. And basically, that's it. Just put it back. The meat is very soft. Just put it back into the container. And look at this. Look at the bone. It has a more of a, like a crunchy, fried taste to it rather than just braised in liquid. And then here is the liquid. There's the adobo. Okay. Filipino adobo. And then I like to have the sauce separate.